I'm Sarah Adam. I'm with Team USA Wheelchair Rugby.
I'm Jeff Butler.
I'm Montreus Hutchison.
I am Brad Hutspeth.
Eric Newby.
My name is Chuck Aoki.
I'm Joe Jackson.
I'm Travis Baker.
And we're here to talk about Disability Pride Month.
Did you know July was Disability Pride Month?
I did not know which month it was, I will be perfectly honest, because there are lots of months these days.
I did not.
I learned about it this month.
I knew that there was a Disability Pride Month. I didn't know it was July.
So I did know that July was Disability Pride Month, and it was around 2015. It was the first month it was celebrated.
What does Disability Pride mean to you?
Everyone has unique things about them. For a lot of us, it's having a disability. For other people, it can be other things. I think that it's important really to lean into what makes you unique.
We're breaking down barriers. That's one thing that it means to me.
Disability Pride to me is really embracing the fact that you have a disability, and that's something that can absolutely empower you, in addition to also, you know, giving you some new insights into life.
I enjoy having the struggles, not necessarily going through them, but being able to say that I come out on the other side.
Disability Pride for me is celebrating our differences and celebrating the uniqueness that people with disabilities provide to this world and the value, inherent value that we have.
What has helped you become more comfortable with your disability?
I think a lot of us here would probably say adaptive sports.
Being around other people that have a disability and, you know, make you feel welcome.
Having a community of people really helped me embrace my disability and understand I wasn't alone out there. There's lots of people like me.
Whenever I first started having that camaraderie with people going through the same thing that you're going through and learning how they're doing things and how they're comfortable in their own skin, I think it goes a long way for somebody that's newly injured.
Get some friends that are in the same boat. You guys can start laughing about your disabilities because we do some funny things that only we get and only we should probably laugh at.
There's therapists telling you how to do things, doctors telling you how to do things, and it's not until you get around a whole bunch of people who have a lot of real life experience that you really start to understand how to live your new life.
It doesn't have to be sports. It could be video games, it could be fashion, it could be dance, it could be, you know, any sorts of number of things, but find your fellow disabled people and find that community, and you'll gain so much confidence and sort of belief in yourself and have a lot of pride in what you bring to the table.
If you could pick one access barrier to remove from society, what would it be?
First and foremost would be carpet.
Every time my friends or cousins or family kind of plan something to go out, steps is always a barrier that we run into.
I think carpet is useless. I don't understand the point of carpet. I don't know why we have carpet.
Things on a really high shelf. Sometimes I'll take something from a low shelf and toss it up to knock something off from a high shelf in a store.
It's soft. It's nice to lay on, but like, do you walk into like an airport and just lay on the carpet, or do you walk around your place of work and just lay down on the floor? No.
When you get a to-go order from like Chipotle or something, and you go off of Uber Eats or whatever, and you go in to get it, and it's all the way up top. Real pain in the butt.
If you want to have it in your own home in like one room, that's fine. But other than that, I am of the opinion that carpet should be banned from every public space in America. And then on top of that, I also think we should get rid of stairs for pretty obvious reasons. I don't think they provide a lot of value. Ramps do the same thing. So stairs and carpet.
Who is your disabled role model?
My role models, when I was first disabled, I started playing rugby right away. So it was always those guys that were really good and on Team USA, guys like Bob Lujano, Andy Cohn, Brian Kirkland, Will Grew, Nick Springer.
Tatiana McFadden, I really admire the way that she uses parasport to change people's mentality on disability and advocate for inclusion.
There's a guy named Dan Price who is also a quad, actually. He's my basketball coach. He was tough, he was really hard on us. You know, and I never had someone be as hard on me as he was. He was like, no, you're gonna do this better. We're gonna do this again, we're gonna do this again, we're gonna do this again until we get it right. And he imparted a lot of lessons to me about how to be a great athlete, how to be a competitor, how to train.
Judy Heumann was an incredible person for advocacy. There are people out there, but I really think that we could use some more role models.
What is a common misconception about Paralympians or disabled athletes that you'd like to dispel?
That we're soft, and we're not.
We're not here for a feel-good pat on the back. We're here to train and to get better and eventually bring home a gold medal.
We train our butts off every day to be able to compete at this level. There's the same intensity to having coaches that still hold us accountable and treat us just as anybody else.
I challenge anyone to get in a chair and we could battle it out and you could see for yourself, like, it's not easy, you know, we still put the work in.
We're not there to have fun, we're there to win.
We are professional athletes, we grind like professional athletes, we have to eat right, sleep right, and kind of focus our whole lives around this.